cheering on the place somewhere where basketball was, the fan base of what I've seen, seen the recent games, seen the games where they play against you, hit the half court, looking at the fan base, how crazy they get. It's just, that's a big part, the history, the championships, not a lot of schools, universities have that prestige, and Coach Mays is also a big part. From the first day, I met Coach Mays and talked on the phone. It was just a clicking moment. To be honest with you, I didn't even see myself coming to UNLV at first.
You do get some free time.
When I talked to Coach Mays, I had to. I had to be a part of what he was trying to build here. We connected on and off the court. Talked more about basketball, after basketball. I just felt like, as a coach, and you can invent that for your player, even though I'm only going to have one year, it's a lifetime, relationship and things like that I'm going to have. He told me that, even though it might be, me and CJ might be, the youngest players that have him as a coach, after this, no matter what we need, on a daily basis, after life, he said he got us, and I just have to be a part of that, something like that. First call, we just talked, he said he knew, a lot of coaches were going to try to sell me to university, and he's going to be open and honest with me, say what he has, what he's about, if I want to be a part of it, and, we just talk, every day. Every day, 3-4 times a day, we just talk, just have conversations. Even just more about basketball, just see how my family's doing. He was the only coach in the recruiting process. He talked to my mom, all my brothers, my two sisters, my cousin. He was all in with it. My family liked him. We prayed about it, talked about it every day. And
if I get a chance to watch
my family wouldn't tell me what decision to make, but when I told them I was leaning towards me and Coach Mays, they were like, okay, that's what we wanted to tell you too. We just couldn't say we wanted to make our own decision.